Before starting my presentation, I wanted to thank the organizer for inviting me today and giving me the opportunity to talk about B cells in multiple sclerosis and the immune reconstitution after multiple sclerosis therapy. This one is my disclosures. The talk included three parts. We go to the role of B cells in adaptive immunity, the abnormality of B cells in multiple sclerosis, and the last part we talk about the immune reconstitution after multiple sclerosis treatment. So for a few minutes we change the topic. So the landmark studies that led to discovery of B cells started with these two publications in 1965 in Nature and 1966 in Journal Experimental Medicine, working with the chicken, Max Cooper and Robert Good, with the collaboration of Raymond Peterson, demonstrated for the first time that cells developed in the bursal are able to produce antibody. Later, this paper published in 1964 in Nature, John Owen with Max Cooper demonstrated for the first time that hematopoietic tissues are able to differentiate in vitro B cells. So this publication started to demonstrate that bone marrow serves the same function of bursal in the chicken. So it is able to produce from hematopoietic stem cells, start the generation differentiation of T cells in thymus and B cells in the lymphoid organs. After 50 years, our understanding about the developmental pathways and the immune function of B cells is improved. We know that B cells produce antibody producing plasma cells, differentiate the immunological memory with the memory B cells, but also are able to regulate the immune responses, the inflammatory immune responses, by regulatory B cells. We know that we are a different subset of B cells, B1 cells that mainly originate in the fetal liver and contain two subsets, B1A and B1B. B2 cells that derive from bone marrow are able to are the progenitors of follicular B cells and marginal zone B cells, from which differentiate memory, the immunological memory, so the switched memory B cells and plasma cells. And also this the last but not less important regulatory B cells that through the production of a cytokine, anti-inflammatory cytokine interleukin 10, is able to suppress immune responses. The B cell tolerance is the mechanism that reduces the probability to generate the autoreactive B cells and is established in several checkpoints. We talk about the cell tolerance during the development of B cells in bone marrow and peripheral tolerance in secondary lymphoid organs. The B cell tolerance includes several mechanisms that go to the gene rearrangement and to the clonal positive selection. So the development of B cells start in bone marrow from hematopoietic stem cells. We have different types of subsets of cells, pro-B cells, pre-B cells, to reach the mature B cells. They have a functional BCR receptor. When they are ready, these mature B cells migrate to the secondary lymphoids, where differentiate the follicular B cells and marginal zone B cells. The link, extremely important, between immature B cells, these mature B cells, are transitional B cells that include the T1 and T2. When the transitional B cells become mature B cells, they have two opportunities to differentiate in follicular B cells that generate the germinal center, or differentiate in marginal zone B cells that differentiate short-lived memory B cells and short-lived plasma cells. These cells are very important for the presenting antigen to T cells. When follicular B cells, when the What is the germinal center? It's a macrostructure that differentiates inside the follicles after immunization or contact with the pathogens. Everything starts with the stimulation of naive T cells and naive B cells that go in active proliferation, interact with each other. And the B cells are able to differentiate in short-lived plasma cells, memory B cells, o they start to differentiate this microstructure, the germinal center. The dynamic of the germinal center is represented from two parts, the dark zone and the light zone. In the dark zone, we have a proliferative follicular B cells that start this somatic hypermutation that give to differentiate of immunoglobulin for different type of antigens. These follicle B cells, after somatic hypermutation, can migrate in the light zone, where they have a contact with the follicular dendritic cells and T follicular cells, T follicular regulatory cells, to start this class switching recombination that change the isotype of immunoglobulin and also the effector function. When they pass the clonal selection, they can differentiate the switching memory B cells and the long-lived plasma cells and spread to the tissue. Regarding the regulatory B cells, the study started in mouse and later on in human. We have a lot of evidence of the existence of Breg in the immune system. In human, we have these two important publications, Flaubert and Mauri, and Wattenscheider. Blair and Mauri demonstrated the presence of these transitional B cells. They have high expression of CD24 and high expression of CD38. They have the capacity to suppress Th1 cells, but they show that these cells are completely dysfunctional in systemic lupus erythematosus. Tether demonstrate also the presence of another B10 cells, regulatory B10 cells, that are able to release interleukin-10, but they have high expression of CD24 and CD27, that is also a marker of memory B cells. We don't know the commitment of Bregs because respected the Treg, we don't have the transcription factor. What we know that the differentiation started from immature B cells upon different type of stimulation, so like receptor stimulation or CD40 stimulation. When they become a Breg, are able to release anti-inflammatory cytokine like interleukin-10, interleukin-35, and TGF-beta. We know from the literature that also this Treg can differentiate also in plasma blasts and plasma cells, regulatory B cells. They are able to release anti-inflammatory cytokine like interleukin-10 and TGF-beta and regulatory immunoglobulin IgA and IgG4. The role of Bregs in the immune system, as demonstrated in several papers, and they show that Bregs are able to suppress by the release of interleukin-10, NK cells, cytotoxic CD8 T cells, proliferation and release of inflammatory cytokine from CD4 T cells, and the differentiation of memory B cells. Also, Bregs are able to differentiate in Breg, in Treg, not differentiate, so they are able to induce the proliferation differentiation of the Treg and to suppress the phagocytosis in monocytes. Abnormalities in B cells was also shown in different papers. B cells show high in multiple sclerosis, show high release of pro-inflammatory cytokine, TNF-alpha, interleukin-6, GM-CSF, and lymphotoxin beta. And these cytokines demonstrated to induce the activation of astrocytes and macroglia. We have the ability of B cells to aggregate with the T cells and follicular dendritic cells in the leptomeninges and generate these ectopic lymphoid follicles. We know that a biomarker of the disease, multiple sclerosis, the oligoclonal band located in the CSF of patients of multiple sclerosis. We know that there is a dysfunction of Breg in release interleukin 10 in patients, and we know also that B cells are able to induce the activation of autoreactive T cells in the central nervous system. Regarding the oligoclonal bands, 95% of patients with MS show high increase of oligoclonal bands in the CSF. And for this used like as a diagnostic biomarker. Immunoglobulin IgM, oligoclonal bands, was detected also in the CSF of patients less frequently, but associated with worse disease course. The specificity of these oligoclonal bands was investigated. They show high specificity for ubiquitous intracellular proteins that are released during tissue destruction and also in against myelin lipids. But this type of antibodies was also observed in other autoimmune disease. Antibodies, oligoclonal bands investigation show also this immunoglobulin are able to link MOG and MBP. Neuropathological study in post-mortem brain also show the presence of CD8 T cells in perivascular infiltrates in white matter lesions. But the important aspect is this generation of ectopic lymphoid follicles in the leptomeninges, this aggregate of B cells with T and dendritic cells that create this structure similar to germinal center. The analysis of oligoclonal the B cells in the CSF show that they have a high somatic hyper mutation that show the activation derived from antigens than by standard activation. The importance of these ectopic lymphoid follicles was described in progressive secondary MS because it looks like that are associated to cortical demyelination. There is a gradient of loss of a neuron and astrocytes associated with activation of astrocytes and macroglia. The hypothesis that these germinal centers are able not only to produce immunoglobulins, but also release cytokines that increase the activation astrocytes and macroglia and use the demyelination and the neuron loss. Also, we have a lot of papers that demonstrate the abnormal immune auto pro-inflammatory B cells in patients with MS. Especially this paper showed that the activation of B cells in vitro release more pro-inflammatory cytokines TNF-alpha, lymphotoxin beta, and GM-CSF than healthy controls. Also, there is a distinct effector cytokine profile of memory-naive human B cell subset different in multiple sclerosis patients compared to healthy controls. Experiment in vitro demonstrated that B cells are able to release a secretory factor extremely toxic for oligodendrocytes and neuron. And this paper also demonstrated the ability of B cells to activate in the brain, the autoreactive CD4 T cells. So also B cells can present the antigen. Several papers also demonstrated that we have in multiple sclerosis patients a dysfunction of Breg, so we have a imbalance between B effector cells and the Breg. Not only there is a reduction of interleukin 10 in patients during the relapsing compared remission, but also our group demonstrated that these transitional Breg are not able in relapsing remitting patients to suppress CD3 activated cells in releasing interferon. This is considering the important role of B cells in multiple sclerosis, started several therapy that several therapy started in as a treatment for the disease that target B cells like rituximab or crilizumab, or indirectly B and T cells like adalimumab. Several publications have also investigated this treatment during this treatment, the immune reconstitution of B cells. And this chart summarizes all the results, all the investigation, the results that we have until now. We can see the immune reconstitution of B cells in the CSF and the blood. And all the studies, some studies have also investigated the markers for B cells. Treatment like rituximab or crilizumab induce a strong depletion of B cells in the CSF and in peripheral blood. We have also a reduction of T cells in the CSF that is not observed in the peripheral blood. When the B cells repopulate the immune system, in rituximab is evident a massive presence of naive regulatory B cells compared switched memory B cells, while when in ocrelizumab we observe the presence also of the switched memory B cells compared naive BREC. So the two treatments show a different repopulation of B cells after depletion. Regarding alemtuzumab that target B and T cells, we observe a consistent depletion of B and T cells in the CSF and also in periphery. But in periphery also we have a repopulation. The repopulation started for B cells before T cells. And the repopulation of B cells is complete after 8 months alemtuzumab treatment when T cells, the repopulation of T cells is observed after 3 years. After alemtuzumab treatment, the analysis of B cells immune reconstitution after treatment show a massive increase of naive B cells and regulatory B cells compared switched memory B cells. We don't have, we have only one study regarding the immune reconstitution of B cells after hematopoietic stem cells treatment, but was done with mass cytometry compared the other study where the investigation of immune reconstitution was done with flow cytometry. In this study, that is the only one that investigated the memory reconstitution after hematopoietic stem cell treatment, show an increase of naive B cells after B cells immune reconstitution. So because we don't we have regarding the B cells immune reconstitution after hematopoietic stem cells, we are ongoing to a clinical trial that BTMS compare. We compare the best available therapy versus autologous hematopoietic stem cells. Another clinical trial, STARMS, where we are going to compare autologous hematopoietic stem cells with the high efficacy standard therapy, and including B cell depleting agents, so ocrelizumab and alemtuzumab. From both of the studies, have the intention to investigate the mechanism of longer remission after these two types of treatment. And there is the intention to complete, to increase what we know about, it's not going back, yes, what we know about, sorry, the immune reconstitution of B cells in hematopoietic after hematopoietic stem cells treatment and in alemtuzumab. I want to thank you for the attention.
Thank you.